Hey guys, this is Amit and today I'll be showing you the modifications that I did in my HO scale model train when I replaced the stock light bulb with some SMD LEDs. I'll also do a quick comparison between the stock light and the LEDs. This is an Athearn GP38-2 which looks kind of like the WDM-2G multi-genset of Indian Railways. I have a few old footage that will show you exactly what was lacking in the stock setup. In this picture, you can clearly see that the headlights are not lit, even though the cabin and the number boards are lit up. This old clip also features the stock light as I was testing the scratch-built pressure sensors. Near the end of this clip, you can probably see the sensors, or at least where the sensors were placed as I manually triggered them for testing purpose. And then here you can see the interior of the cabin with the stock light bulb inside the cabin. The old lighting setup didn't light up the tracks or anything else outside the cabin, but I wanted something that would light up the tracks somewhat close to what an actual train does. Again, in this last clip of the old setup, note that the rear light doesn't light up when the loco starts to run in reverse, as the rear light was absent in the stock setup. So we didn't have any light at all when it was reversing, which looks pretty dull for a DCC locomotive. So I opened up the model, looked into the connections of the decoder, figured out the connection for the rear light, and added two LEDs for the rear, and replace the stock light bulb in the front with two LEDs. Now, in order to limit the current and protect the LEDs from burning out, I also added a 5.6 kilo ohm resistor in series. I was really happy with the rear light because it did light up the track fairly well. As it takes the turn and reaches the straight part of the track, you can see how much light we get from the rear light. The front light was also fairly decent and did light up the track, but due to the hood in the front which obstructed the path of light, there was some shadow as well. So the part of track immediately in front of the loco was dark, but the far side was well lit up. Probably the shadow cannot be avoided due to the lack of ditch lights in the model. Now, coming to the current lighting setup, there are two small problems which can be solved to get exactly the type of lighting which I was talking about earlier. First, there is a slight leakage of light just near the rear wheels. As usual, the rear light turns on when the loco moves with the long hood forward, so you can see the difference in the amount of light incident on my hand. Now, coming to the second problem, In the front light, there is again some leaked light, but that's through the front window. I have a solution to both these problems, but I'll have to work on that a little bit. So I'll be back with that in a later video. Now, coming to the LEDs that I plan to use, these are the LEDs that I'll use to make model streetlights. The smaller one is called SMD2035, and the larger one is called SMD5630. I soldered them with some thin magnet wire that I salvaged from some electronic wastes. Now, just to show you how small these LEDs are, if you don't know by the numbers already, the bigger one, which is SMD5630, is warm white color and it's about 5.6mm by 3mm, as you can see here. I prefer to use this warm white color for the streetlights actually. And the smaller one, that is the SMD2035, is 2.8mm by 3.5mm. And this is a cool white color, so I can change its color easily according to my needs using a proper filter like a colored plastic or something like that. In the next clip, you'll see these two lights lighting up the track like a nearby street light would do. So you'll get an idea of how the train would look at night with the street lights turned on. And you can see some details of the wheel bogies, which was completely dark without the lights. I will reduce the brightness later in the actual model to make it realistic. So that's all for this video. Let me know what you think about this, and if you have any suggestions, leave it in the comments below. I'll be back next time with some track conversion techniques I use to convert wooden ties to concrete ties. Hope to see you in the next video, and happy modeling!